Hello everybody, today we are going to see some examples which are depend on the concept midpoint theorem. Okay, we have seen midpoint theorem and converse of midpoint theorem. Okay, then how to use that midpoint theorem in examples, that we are going to see. Okay, so today's our first problem is, in figure D, E and F are respectively the midpoints of sides BC, CA and AB of an equilateral triangle ABC. Prove that DEF is also an equilateral triangle. Okay, once again see, figure is given. In figure, DEF, DE and F are respectively the midpoints of sides BC, CA and AB of an equilateral triangle. Means here, triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. Okay, then D, E and F are the midpoints. D is the midpoint of BC, E is midpoint of AC and F is midpoint of AB. Okay, so and ABC is an equilateral triangle. Means AB is equal to AC is equal to BC. Okay, all sides are equal. Prove that DEF is also an equilateral triangle. We have to prove here. DEF, this triangle is also an equilateral triangle. Okay, so that is that we have to. Okay, so see here, according to the midpoint theorem, yesterday we have seen midpoint theorem. Okay, line joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle, line joining midpoints of two sides of a triangle is that line is up of the third side. Okay, means here. FE is equal to half of BC. Okay, then ED is equal to half of AB and FD is equal to half of AC. Okay, so we are going to use here midpoint. So see carefully here, since we know that line joining midpoints of two sides of triangle. Two sides of triangle is half of the third side. Okay, this is midpoint theorem. We have seen the proof of this theorem. Okay, so now according to this here, F is the midpoint of AB. So if I am going to think about AD. ED is equal to half of AB because E and D are the midpoint of AC and BC. Okay, then ED is half of AB, that is the third side. So ED is equal to half of AB. So this is, I am saying here, first one. Second, FD is equal to half of AC. This is second one. Okay, and last one is remaining. FE is equal to half of BC. FE is equal to half of BC. So this is third one. Okay, ED is equal to half of AB. FD is equal to half of AC. And FE is equal to half of BC. Okay, and here they have told us triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. So we know that AB is equal to AC is equal to BC. Because triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. So if you will take half of all the three sides, okay, then it is also the ratio will be same. Means all the sides will be equal. Suppose I will take half of AB. Definitely it will be equal to half of AC is equal to half of BC. But half of AB is equal to what? ED. So here I am taking half of AB is equal to ED. Half of AC is equal to FD. FD is equal to half of BC is equal to FE. FE. Okay. So from one, first, second and third. Okay, ED is equal to FD is equal to FE. ED ED is equal to FD is equal to FE. All the three sides of this triangle FED are equal. So we can say triangle FED prove that DEF, FED or DEF, triangle DEF is also an equilateral triangle. Okay, so triangle DEF is also an equilateral triangle because all the three sides are equal. Okay. Okay. See here. Second example is prove that four triangles formed by joining in pairs. The midpoint of three sides of a triangle are bounded to each other. Okay, once again, see, figure is given here. Prove that four triangles formed by joining in pairs. Four triangles are formed by joining in pairs. Okay, so see triangle AFE, EFD, FBD, and EDC. Okay, like the four angles or triangles are joined in pairs. The midpoint of the three sides of a triangle are bounded. Midpoint of these three sides, what is given here? F is the midpoint of AB, D is the midpoint of BC, and E is the midpoint of AC. Okay, then they are congruent to each other. Means here we have to prove this triangle 1, 2, 3, and 4 are congruent to each other. Means triangle AF is congruent to this triangle FDE, congruent to FBD, and congruent to this fourth one. Okay, so that is our target that we are going to prove. Okay, so first given thing we will mention here. Four triangles formed by joining in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, F, F, D, and E are the midpoints. Are the midpoints of AB. Then D is the midpoint of BC and AC respectively. Okay, these are the midpoints. Now to prove, what we have to prove? Triangle AFE congruent triangle FDE congruent triangle FBD congruent triangle EDC. Okay, so this we need to show, we need to prove. Okay, so now we will think about proof. Okay, just now we have seen midpoint theorem here. We are going to use, according to the midpoint theorem, FE is equal to half of BC. Okay, FE is equal to half of BC. FE is equal to half of BC. Okay, so from this we can say FE is equal to, if FE is the half of BC, okay, then BD and DC are equal. So we can say FE is equal to BD is equal to CD, is equal to CD or DC. So this is, I am saying first. Okay, FE is half of BC, so we can say FE is equal to BD is equal to CD. Okay, so that is our first thing which we got. Now we will think about second. Okay, FD is equal to, FD is equal to half of AC. FD is equal to half of AC. Okay, so we can say FD is equal to AE is equal to C. So this is our second. Okay, and now FD over FE over, now we will think about ED, third side of inside triangle. ED is equal to half of AB. ED is equal to half of AB. So ED is equal to AF and AB. ED is equal to AF is equal to FB. So this is third. This is third. Okay. So according to the midpoint theorem, here reason you will give for all this by will point here. We will point here. Okay. So now we will think about remaining part. Okay. So now we have these three things. So from that, any two triangles suppose you will take, then we can show that both the triangles are congruent. So now I am taking here AFE in triangle AFE and triangle FDE, AFE and DEF, triangle DEF. I am taking these two triangles. Okay. So here AF is equal to ED. AF is equal to ED. Why? AF is equal to ED. AF is equal to ED. AF and ED are same. That we have shown by midpoint here. Okay. Then AE is equal to FD. AE is equal to FD. AE is equal to FD. Okay. And FE is the common side. So FE is equal to EF. That is common. That is common. Okay. So this is from third. This is from third. And AE is equal to AE is equal to FD. This is from second figure. From second. Or we can say from what? 2 and 3. Directly we can say. Okay. So three sides, all the three sides of triangle AFE are equal to the three sides of triangle FDE. So we can say from this triangle AFE congruent triangle DEF by SSS, side. Okay. Similarly, we can prove triangle FBD congruent to this. We can choose these two triangles, then we can choose these two triangles. Okay. So that only just we need to mention. Similarly, triangle FED congruent FBD, congruent FBD and FED triangle FED congruent triangle EDC, triangle EDC. Okay, so this way we can show all the four triangles are congruent. We have shown here these two triangles are congruent, then we can choose this pair and then we can choose this pair. This is not necessary to show. In one statement we can write. This way only we are going to show all the four triangles, all the remaining pairs are congruent. Okay. So for that you can use these methods. Okay. Okay, see here our third problem is P, Q and R are respectively the midpoints of BC, CA and AB of triangle ABC. PR and BQ meets at point X, CR and PQ meet at point Y. Prove that XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. Once again see, P, Q and R are respectively the midpoints of BC, CA and AB. P, Q and R are the midpoints. P is the midpoint of BC, Q is the midpoint of AC and R is the midpoint of AB. Okay. Then of triangle ABC, PR and BQ, PR and BQ meet at point X. Also, PQ and RC or CR meet at point Y. Okay, and with the help of given things, we have to prove that XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. XY means we need to construct that. XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. Okay, so now first we will mention here given things. What is given? Okay, given PQ and R are midpoints of BC, CA and AB respectively. Okay, PR and PQ meet at point X. PR and BQ meet at point X. Okay, and CR and PQ and PQ meet at 1. Okay, then this is given. What we have to do? To prove XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. This we need to prove. You can avoid this. If you don't want to write here given, given is directly you can take from the question. Okay, that is also okay. Now XY is equal to 1/4 of BC. Now we need to do construction, that is we need to join this XY. That is very simple construction. XY we need to join. So here that we need to mention construction join XY. Okay, so now P, Q and R are the midpoints. So here we will use first midpoint. Okay, so now here improve P is the midpoint of BC. P is the midpoint of BC. So suppose I want to write RQ. RQ is equal to half of BC. RQ is equal to half of BC. RQ is equal to half of BC. Also, RQ is equal to is parallel to BC. RQ is parallel to BC. Okay, according to the midpoint theorem. Midpoint theorem says a line segment which is joining two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and half of it. Means here RQ is parallel to BC and RQ is half of BC. Okay, so this is my midpoint theorem. Midpoint theorem. Okay, RQ is equal to half of BC, RQ is parallel to BC. Okay, so RQ is half of BC, but P is the midpoint. P is the midpoint of BC. So we can say RQ is equal to PP. RQ is equal to BP. RQ is equal to BP and RQ is parallel to BP. RQ equal and parallel. Okay, when one pair of opposite side of a quadrilateral are equal and parallel, that time we can say RBPQ is a parallel. RBPQ. Okay, so RBPQ is a parallelogram. Okay, this is parallel. RBPQ is a parallel. Now we will think about the diagonals of this parallelogram. Okay, we know the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, so here x is the midpoint of RP. X is the midpoint of RP. Understood? So directly we can mention here x is the midpoint. X is the midpoint of RP. Okay. So now same thing we can use for triangle RPCQ. RPC. Okay. So here that way we can give proof y is the midpoint of QP or PQ. Okay, similarly we can prove, or if you want we can explain once again the same thing. Okay, here what we have taken, RQ is equal to BC. RQ is equal to BC. So here we can take RP is equal to half of AC. RP is equal to half of AC by midpoint theorem. Okay, and RP is parallel to AC. RP is parallel to AC. So we can say RP is equal to QC. Is equal to QC because Q is the midpoint of AC. So RP is equal to QC and RP is parallel to QC. RP is parallel to QC. Okay. Here also we got one pair of opposite side of quadrilateral RQCP is equal and parallel. So definitely we can see here also RQ. So RQCP is a parallel. Okay. So Here, what are the which are the diagonals? PQ and RC. Both are diagonals and they are intersecting at point Y. They are intersecting at point Y. And diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. So definitely Y is the midpoint. Y is the midpoint of QP. Y is the midpoint of QP. Okay. Now we have joined X and Y. Okay, XY. X is also midpoint and Y is also midpoint. Okay. So if I want to think about this triangle, in triangle PQR, can we say XY is equal to half of RQ? XY is equal to half of RQ. XY is equal to half of RQ. XY, because this is the line segment which is joining midpoints of two sides of a triangle. So XY is equal to half of RQ, but RQ is equal to half of BC. RQ is also a line segment which is joining two sides of this triangle. So RQ, but here RQ is equal to half of BC. Half of BC. RQ is equal to half of BC. So this value we will put here. This value we will put here. That is XY, because we have to show XY. We have to show in terms of XY. So XY, this I am taking here, XY is equal to half of RQ. At the place of RQ, we will replace this half of BC. That is 1 by 2 into BC. That is 1 by 4 BC. So XY is equal to 1 by 4 BC or 1 fourth of BC. Okay, and that would be, they are asking in the question. Okay, see carefully and solve the same sums again in the note. Okay, see example number 4 is triangle ABC is a triangle right angle at B and P is the midpoint of AC. Prove that PQ is perpendicular to AB, Q is the midpoint of AB, and third one PB is equal to PA is equal to half of AC. Okay. So now first, once again see, triangle ABC is a triangle right angle at B. Triangle ABC is given right angle at B. P is the midpoint of AC. P is the midpoint of AC. Suppose that midpoint we will take here. So P is the midpoint of AC. Okay. So this is point P. Midpoint of AC. Prove that PQ is perpendicular to AB. PQ is perpendicular to AB. Okay. So here, first one, PQ. There is one point on AB that we have to show perpendicular. Okay. So that point is. Okay. So we need to construct a parallel line. So that is our new construction that we need to mention in construction. Construct PQ parallel to BC or CP. Okay, so first thing we will mention here, given things. What is given? Triangle ABC, triangle ABC, right angle at B. Right angle at B. Okay, then P is the midpoint. P is the midpoint. Midpoint of AB. P is the midpoint of AC. AB, AC. Okay. Then we have to do that to prove. Okay. So I am not writing this directly, I am taking this third one, because when we will prove this 1 and 2, that time automatically that these two things we need to use in third source. Okay. So here PB is equal to PA is equal to half of AC. Okay, so now construction. Draw PQ parallel to CB. PQ parallel to CB. From point P through point P. Okay, PQ is parallel to CB. Okay, now we need to think about the proof. Okay, so first we will think about First one, EQ is perpendicular to AB. EQ is perpendicular to the AB. Okay. So we have constructed EQ. EQ is parallel to AB. EQ is parallel to AB. Okay. And angle ABC is equal to 90 degrees. So definitely angle AQP is 90 degrees. Okay. PQ is parallel to BC. PQ is parallel to BC. PQ is parallel to BC. So angle AQP is equal to angle ABC is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. So this is 90 degrees. Okay. Now, EQ perpendicular to AB is what we need to show. This is 90 degree. Angle PQP or BQP is 90 degree. Okay. So AQP, angle AQP plus AQP plus BQP, angle BQP is equal to 180. Okay. Linear pair, forming linear pair. This plus this. From that we know AQP is 90 degree. So that we will put here 90 degree plus angle BQP is equal to 180. So angle BQP is equal to 180 minus 90. So 180 minus 90 is 90 degree. Angle BQP is 90. If angle BQP is 90 degree, then we can say PQ. So PQ is perpendicular to AB. PQ is perpendicular to AB. So here we got first thing. Okay. Now second, they are asking show that Q is the midpoint of AB. This is very simple. Here PQ is parallel to CB. PQ is parallel. PQ is parallel to CB. That way we have done the search. PQ is parallel to CB. Therefore, Q is the midpoint of AB. Q is the midpoint of AB. Okay, according to the midpoint. Understood? So if this is Q is not midpoint, then definitely PQ will not be parallel to BC. So therefore we can say therefore PQ PQ is the midpoint of side AB, midpoint of side BC, sorry, AB, midpoint of side AB. Q is the midpoint of side AB. Got it, everybody? If when only it is possible PQ is parallel to BC, PQ is parallel to BC, that means Q is the midpoint of AB. If Q is not midpoint, then PQ will not be parallel to BC because P is the midpoint, that is given. Okay. Now third thing we need to show, PB is equal to PA. PB means this, PB is equal to PA is equal to half of AC. Okay. So for this third one, we will think about these two triangles, triangle ABQ and triangle ABQ and triangle BPQ. Okay. Here, see PQ is common side. So that I am taking here, PQ is equal to PQ. Common side for both the triangles. Okay. Then AQ is equal to BQ. AQ and BQ are equal. AQ is equal to BQ because here we know, here we have given proof, Q is the midpoint of AB. So here we can say this is from second. Okay. From second, AQ is equal to BQ because Q is the midpoint. Okay, and AQP angle AQP is equal to angle BQP. Angle BQP both are 90 degree, each 90 degree or right angle. Okay, so side angle side by SAS criteria, the given triangles are congruent. So triangle ABQ congruent, triangle BPQ are congruent by side angle side by SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Understood? So here what we have to do, PB is equal to PA, PB is equal to PA is equal to half of AC. So here PA is equal equal to what? So the, if these two triangles are congruent, then we can say PA is equal to PB. PA is equal to PB by CPCB. By CPCB. PA and PB are corresponding sides. So triangles are congruent. So PA and PB are equal. Okay. So here we can say PA is equal to half of AC. PA is equal to half of AC. But PA and PB are equal, so we can see here PB is equal to also half of AC. So here, according to the given, PB is equal to PA is equal to half of AC. Half of AC. Okay. This example is from NCERT. Some examples we have seen today, that is from NCERT exercise. Okay. So solve this carefully.